What is fintech? In this video, I want to run through what the definition of fintech is, as it gets thrown around a fair bit as one of the buzzwords in the IT domain. We work with a number of companies that are defined as fintech. It's an area where I spent a lot of my time building products and software in the fintech space. I'm going to approach this video from the standpoint of custom software development, because fintechs realistically are custom software. They're a platform that's in the financial space that's backed by technology. I'm going to run through four key points in this video to describe how fintech are. Firstly, how is fintech defined? Secondly, what are the types of fintech? Thirdly, what and who are the fintech leaders? And finally, what role does custom software play in the fintech space? I'm Matt Grace, Managing Director of Flying Donkey. Let's get into it. First up, how is fintech defined? Fintech is essentially the combination of the words financial and technology to form fintech. Essentially, it's the use of technology in the financial space in order to drive efficiencies, improve features, and lower cost. I'll list out a few areas impacted by fintech companies, but this range is always expanding month on month. Some of the big spaces we see fintech companies playing in are mobile payments, insurance, blockchain, financial services, and generally banking. Fintech really concentrates on innovating the way that financial services are delivered and how money is transferred from person to person, either in a country or around the globe. While you may have heard of the term fintech, a lot of the companies or banking products you use are probably considered to be fintech companies. In previous videos, I've briefly spoken around some of the logics and algorithms that go into various software products. And because the fintech space is something we deal in, I'm fairly familiar with how things operate there. I have discussed things around the blockchain and AI versus rules-based, and these two technologies are very pertinent to fintech corporations. Being the financial services, technology really drives a huge portion of their business, and they're always experimenting on how blockchain and other technologies can improve their business. But to summarize, what is fintech? It's simply the combination of technology in the financial space in order to bring together better outcomes and features for their clients while driving efficiency and costs. All right, point two, let's look at some examples about what are types of fintechs. Generally speaking, the products offered by the banks are very slow to adapt and move. Banks are large corporations with many tens, potentially hundreds of thousands of employees, with systems operating for many millions of clients. In the fintech space, what happens is a company will come along who's nimble and agile and literally wants to pick off just one small component of a bank. Let's just say, for example, a bank offers 100 services. A fintech will come along and try and innovate in one or two of those areas. Because they're only concentrating on a smaller subset of the features, it's easier for them to deliver a new and modern technology. Let's have a look at a few of these in practice. Mobile payments. So while mobile payments are generally considered commonplace these days, it wasn't always the way. And it was fintechs who led the way in the mobile space prior to banks coming on board. Now, while banks had the customer base and the feature set already online, they didn't bring that to mobile payments till very much later. A good example of a fintech in this space is Wise or TransferWise. They are an overseas-based company, but they're ones who've innovated in the FX space. They allowed mobile payments to any country around the world from a mobile platform almost instantly. Wise approached the problem differently to how banks had previously done it, and that is using a peer-to-peer model of not actually sending money across borders. In traditional foreign exchange payments, money is sent to a centralized exchange, for example, to exchange Australian dollars for USD. But in Wise's case, two of their founders founded the company a slightly different way. And this is where the innovation began. One of the founders was from Eastern Europe and he moved to London. And another one of the founders was in London and he moved to Eastern Europe. Essentially, they were living in each other's hometowns. Now, when they got their salaries paid, they each had to go and exchange this money on an exchange and lose between 3 and 5%. They thought to themselves, there has to be a better way. And Wise, or TransferWise as it's known, was born. Simply speaking, rather than paying across the markets and losing their 3 to 5%, each person in their country received their dollars and paid for it in that country. So for example, the guy who was from Eastern Europe and lived in London paid for the guy who moved to Eastern Europe directly to his London bank account. They agreed on the middle rate of FX, and therefore they actually skipped all the exchanges. Wise is now just the culmination of this process put into technology to form a formidable fintech. Wise recently IPO'd and is now valued at a multi-billion dollar company. Wise is a fintech who innovated in the space of mobile payments, particularly in foreign exchange, and they've done really well. Banks are now starting to offer a similar service or are partnering with these fintechs to provide the same service. Insurance industry. Let's have a quick look at another example of how the insurance industry is becoming a fintech. Again, if we look at something that's going to drive this, it's going to be an innovative change. Now, insurance as a product hasn't really changed in hundreds of years. You pay your premium and you receive the payment if something goes wrong. With the advent of mobile phones and also as Internet of Things technologies, insurance companies could monitor and track things like never before. One key thing here was that car insurance. So for car insurance, the more you use the car, obviously the more at risk you are of having a crash. So what they did was they put trackers in people's cars, either on their phone or with a small device. And people who used their car less or operated in a more safe manner, their premiums reduced. And for people who drove more recklessly or had more crashes, their premiums increased. This is a technology product in the finance space, and therefore it's considered a fintech product. Again, once these fintech people start innovating, the larger companies will take this on board either through acquisition or adding a feature of their own, and it becomes more commonplace. But this is a good example of fintechs in the insurance space. Mobile banking. Again, fairly commonplace these days, but it is considered a fintech. Being able to check your balance, view a statement, or pay a payment on the go on your mobile phone without talking to anyone in a call center is a technology revolution. This mobile payment is now commonplace, and generally all the big banks offer this functionality. But again, this is technology driving financial innovation, and realistically, it allows banks to lower costs and improve efficiency. Mobile payments on their own are considered a financial technology and therefore could be shortened to be a fintech. Cryptocurrency and blockchain. This has really been the buzzword for the past 5 or 6 years, and I've done a previous video on my thoughts on the blockchain. While I think the technology is interesting, its applications so far have been lacking, and some of the things that it's trying to achieve are actually achievable slightly easier in traditional technology. You can watch more on that video on our blog. Regardless, blockchain and cryptocurrency are both financial technologies and therefore sit under the fintech banner. They're more operating around the revolution of the blockchain technology, and they're more concentrating on the decentralization, public publishing, and irrevocability of the blockchain. Some of these things in the future may become very key pivotal points of a future fintech. For right now, the actual application of these technologies is yet to be proven. While small scale things have come out of the blockchain and cryptocurrency technology, and obviously on blockchain is the Bitcoin. Bitcoin has obviously taken the world by storm as an investment asset, but as far as use for payments, it is used for payments, but due to its high volatility, it doesn't really lend itself very well to payments. Again, I mentioned more of this on my previous video. I still think possibly in the future, blockchain will find its home and will drive the next generation of fintechs. But for now, the technology needs to mature and find its home in a piece of functionality that makes sense for a business to drive it. All right, what are fintech lenders? If you go back to when I started, I said that essentially a fintech is a business that picks off one or two small sections of what a bank does. Now, one of the key parts of what a bank does is it lends money out to people. Obviously, it does many more wide things like taking deposits, insurance products, etc. But if we concentrate here on lending, these key parts become their standalone fintech. A couple of key examples here of what fintech lenders are. They could be a traditional home loan provider, they could be a business loan provider, or that can be a peer-to-peer lending marketplace. If we just break down the home loan lending for a moment, what essentially we're saying here is a business that stands alone and all they do is lend money for home loans. And obviously you can see what this means. A fintech that is a home loan lender only concentrates on lending home loans. It's going to concentrate on building out a platform that's going to be a fintech product. This product is going to concentrate on a great onboarding process, most probably trying to reduce onboarding times. Therefore, if you're looking to refinance and you're looking for a home loan product and you want to onboard in a more seamless way, you'll probably look at one of these fintechs rather than the big four banks. So these companies are innovating in the space of lending, but to be totally honest, a lot of these companies are backed by the banks themselves because obviously they don't run a deposit arm. They need to source the funds for these loans. And that's why they truly are a fintech product. What I expect to see over the coming years is more and more of these products to be absorbed by the banks, and therefore the fintechs will be acquired and their products will be rolled out on the banks' platforms themselves. A good example of this is TikTok, which is a home loan only lender. TikTok is backed by Bendigo and Adelaide Bank, and the reason for here is pretty simple. As I mentioned, while they're an innovator in a home loan space, essentially that is writing of loans. They still need funds to do that, and Bendigo and Adelaide are the ones who provide that facility for them. Obviously, Bendigo and Adelaide want a slice of the pie, so they'll own part of the lender, with the idea being that in the future, they may potentially acquire them. This is what fintechs are. They're smaller, more concentrated companies that concentrate on innovating in technology in the financial space. What is the role of custom software in fintechs? Well, I hope that's fairly obvious now because fintechs are essentially custom software platforms that are concentrating in the financial space in technology. Obviously, every single fintech is going to have to build their own custom platform and integrate out with a number of other platforms. Whether that be the home loan provider, TikTok that we mentioned, Wise or TransferWise, as we mentioned around payments, or a bank itself trying to innovate in one of its products. All of these fintechs are essentially technology plays in the financial space, trying to drive innovation, improve efficiency, and lower cost. If you're looking to launch a fintech or interested in the financial space and how technology can approach it, here at Flying Donkey, we have a number of clients in this space and we're happy to share our experience with you. If you want to start a fintech, feel free to get in touch and let's have a chat.